Good morning, friends. Happy Monday. And I'm sorry that I can't be there with you today, but you are in good hands. And we're going to continue on with our packet and with Unit 3 and solving equations. I know you just warmed up with a few practice problems from our previous homework. And so let's go ahead and get started with this lesson. We're going to take what we did in 3.4 with two-step equations, and we're going to skip over two-step word problems for right now, and we're going to go on to 3.5 multi-step equations. So that's today's lesson, is 3.5 multi-step equations. I'm going to abbreviate equations Eqns. So multi-step equations are just that. They're equations that have multiple steps, okay? So our process is still going to be the same. We're going to find that variable and get that variable by itself. But before we do that, we're going to have to do some distribution and some combining like terms. And then we're going to have to get y by itself or whatever the variable is. So again, if you are a step person, following these steps right here are going to be really helpful for you as you begin to solve the equations. I would ask that you stick with it today and do the very best that you can and keep writing, and then we'll go back and answer any questions that you have, okay? All right, so let's look at our first problem. I'm going to blow my screen up a little bit so we can see it. Says our first step is to distribute if needed. So we don't have any parentheses, so we don't have to distribute. Remember, distributing would be if the problem looks something like this. Remember, and we do this little rainbow thing where we distribute into the parentheses. We don't have that in problem number one. Okay. Step number two says combine like terms if needed. And I would like for us to add on each side. So we're not going across the equal sign yet. We're just looking on each side of the equation. So if we need to, you can draw your line. And on the left side, it's just negative 20, so there's nothing to go with it. So if we look on the right side, I have a negative 4x and a negative 6x. These are like terms, and they are the same sign, and so I add them. So when I add 4 and 6, I get 10x. And it's a negative 10x because they're both negative, equals negative 20. So again, all I did was combine like terms. They were the same. And now I have negative 10x equals negative 20. And now, guys, this is a problem like 3.1 or 3.2 when we just did basic equations, one-step equations. If I want to get x by itself, this is being multiplied, and so if I want to get x by itself, I'm going to divide by negative 10. But remember, whatever you do to one side, you do to the other side. So we're going to divide by negative 10 over here. I'm left with x equals 2. Now, if I wanted to check that, because remember we said you can check your solutions, and I told you that on a test, there's no reason for you to get this wrong if you can check your problem. So if we wanted to check this, I would have negative 20 equals negative 4, and we know that our x is 2, minus 6 times negative 2. I'll give you a second to write that down. Oh, not negative 2, whoops, just 2. So again, I'm taking my original equation here, and I'm plugging in a 2 for each of the x's to be able to solve. So I have negative 20, that doesn't change. Negative 4 times 2 is negative 8. Negative 6 times 2 is negative 12. We know these are the same signs, so I'm going to add them. which gives me negative 20, and that does equal negative 20 on the other side. So x equals 2 is my answer. So again, there's no reason for you to get this wrong, because you can go back and check yourself. All right, so that's our first multi-step equation. And if you need to, you can pause the video and slow things down. Number two, so again, we're gonna look on either side of the equation. There's nothing to combine over here on the right side. Okay. On the left side, do we have any like terms? Remember, for them to be like terms, they have to have the same variable. And so we could see we have a negative 15a and a 7a. Well, negative 15 and a positive 7, we know negative 15 plus 7, those are opposite signs. And for opposite signs, we really subtract. So negative 15 plus 7 is really negative 8a, that a comes with it, minus 110 equals 90. And now this is a lesson, like, this is a problem, like, from lesson 3.4, where you have a two-step equation. So, again, we're going to isolate our variable. Our variable's over here. That's what we want to get by itself, is that A. But we have to do opposite PEMDAS. Remember we talked about that? We talked about, do you have any addition or subtraction to get rid of first? And we do. We have that negative 110. So I'm going to add 110 to both sides. And I have negative 8a equals 90 plus 110 is 200. Okay, we're still doing reverse PEMDAS, so I took care of my addition and subtraction. Now I look to see, do I have any multiplication or division? And I do. I have negative 8 times a. So to get rid of that negative 8, it's being multiplied, so I have to divide. Remember, we do inverse operations. Remember to take the negative with the 8. Running out of room. And I have a equals, use your multiplication charts if you need to. Should give me negative 25. Positive divided by a negative is a negative. And 8 goes into 200 25 times. So A equals negative 25. All right, so we've done two so far. If you're still pretty confused or lost, we're going to do several more. So I just ask that you keep writing with me. And we're gonna press on. We're gonna do some more examples, and hopefully that will help. Remember, this video is on YouTube, so you can also go back and review it on your own. But we're following our four steps here every time, okay? All right, let's look at number three. So again, our first step is to combine like terms on each side. So if you need to draw your equals sign down to figure out which two sides you have. There's nothing that goes with this negative 9 over here, so I know that's just going to be brought down. On the left side, I have like terms that are the negative 8p and a positive 7p. They both have a p, and so that's why they are like terms. Negative 8 plus 7, those are opposite signs, so we are subtracting negative 8 plus 7. You're really subtracting that. So that gives you negative 1p. And remember, we said you can write negative 1p or just negative p, but it's the same thing. So those are gone. And now I have my minus 2. So my equation now is negative 1p minus 2 equals negative 9. Okay, and then remember, I'm doing reverse PEMDAS. So do I have any addition and subtraction? I do. I have that minus 2, so to get rid of it, we do the opposite, remember? So I'm going to add 2 to both sides. So negative 1p equals negative 9 plus 2 gives you negative 7. Remember, p is not really by itself because we have that negative 1 there. So in order to get rid of the negative 1, remember when it's smashed together like that, it means multiplication. So the opposite operation is to divide by a negative 1. But whatever you do on one side, you have to do on the other side. Remember, folks, this is not subtraction. This is a division. So negative 7 divided by a negative 1. Negative divided by a negative. Use your little triangle thing. Oops. Remember your triangle thing, that plus, minus, minus. If you cover up the negative negative, you're left with a positive. So this is a positive 7. And again, you can go back and check yourself. All right, number 4. Step number 1 says to distribute if you can. And actually on number 4, we can distribute, right? So I can distribute this negative 4 here. Negative 4 times a negative 6y, negative times a negative is a positive. So this will be positive 24y. And then this negative 4 goes also to this negative 3. Remember, when you're multiplying, you're also multiplying the sign that goes with it. So negative 4 times a negative 3 is a positive 12. Equals 12 over here on this side. Okay, so again, now we draw our line. We're trying to get y by itself. We're doing reverse PEMDAS. Do I have any addition or subtraction? I do. So we are subtracting 12. Subtracting 12. So I have 24y. 12 minus 12 is 0. We haven't had a problem like this before. That's okay. We're still going to follow a process. After addition and subtraction, we look to get rid of multiplication and division. And this 24 and y are being multiplied. Okay. So to get rid of it, we're going to divide by 24. We're going to divide by 24. So we have y by itself. 0 divided by any number. Can you take 0 and divide it into anything? No, because there's nothing to divide, right? So 0 divided by anything is just 0. Look what happens when we plug back in on this problem. If I have 12 equals negative 4 times 6 times 0 minus 3, negative 6 times 0. Well, negative 6 times 0 is just 0, so this whole thing is just gone. So now I have 12 equals negative 4, parentheses, negative 3. Negative 4, parentheses, negative 3 is 12. 12 equals 12. Perfect. All right, number 5. Don't get a little nervous. It's a fraction. We can handle fractions. So instead of distributing the fractions here, the 1/4 to here and here, let's make life a little bit easier. And this process may be new to you, so just stick it out. If I wanted to get the 1/4 away, remember we talked about if the problem looked like this, 1/4 x equals something over here. We talked about multiplying by the reciprocal. Do you guys remember doing that? We flipped it. Okay, so the same thing is true when you have a problem up here of this magnitude. You can still get rid of this 1/4 by multiplying each side by 4 over 1. on the left side cancels out. And we are just left with 6c minus 2. On the right side, 7 times 4 is 28. Well, 7's over 1, too. Remember, when you multiply fractions, you're multiplying straight across. Okay. So 7 times 4 is 28. 1 times 1 is 1, which is really just 28. So my new problem becomes 6c minus 2 equals 28. And you guys can go ahead and solve that. I don't know what happened here. Oh dear. Okay. So if I have 6c minus 2 equals 28, you guys can solve it from here. Go ahead, take a minute and do that. I'll give you some working music. Keep solving. All right. I mean, who doesn't love the Beach Boys, guys? Come on. All right. So if we added 2 to both sides, I get 30 on the right side and 6c by itself. Divide by 6 on each side and c equals 5. Awesome. So remember that while we're doing our homework or we're doing our notes examples, I'm trying to find enough problems in our notes that you'll be able to do your homework just fine. So that's why we're doing a bunch of different examples, okay? So let's take a look at number 6. Remember, the very first step is to distribute if necessary. And on number 6, it is necessary at first to distribute. So we'll go ahead and distribute our 2 here. Go ahead and do it. Is the 2 going to be distributed to the negative 7? No, because it's not in parentheses. So we have minus 7 equals 5. 2b plus 2 minus 7 equals 5. All right, step number 2 says to combine like terms on each side if possible. Well, on the left side, we have a 2 and a negative 7. We can go ahead and combine those. They're opposite signs, so we're really going to subtract, right? So 7 minus 2 leaves us with a 5, and it's a negative 5 because the 7 is bigger. And you guys should be able to take it from here. I'll give you some working music. Go ahead and finish this out. All right, so if we solve this out, we're going to add 5, add 5, 2b equals 10. Remember, now we have to get the b by itself, so we're going to divide by 2, divide by 2, and B is 5. Please raise your hand. I realize I'm not there, but please raise your hand if you got this one right, so that the teacher that is there today with you can make sure that you guys are on the right track. So if you got this, please raise your hand. All right. Let's just take a look at number 7 and talk about number 7. On 7, we have that negative sign out front there. And remember, that's like a negative 1, right? And so negative 1 is going to get distributed. And then it becomes a problem like we just did on number 6. So we're not going to take the time to do number 7, but remember, a negative changes signs, okay? All right, let's look at number 8. So step number 1 is to distribute if necessary. Is there a need to distribute here? Yes. Okay, so here's our equal sign. So we're going to go ahead and distribute here and here. So that 2 times 8v give, oh, I just told you. 2 times 4v gives you 8v. 2 times a negative 3 is negative 6. And now I'm just going to bring these two down. They don't get distributed. They're still part of the problem. I'm just going to bring them down. Minus 8 minus 2v equals 4. Okay, so we distributed if necessary. Then the second step is to combine like terms. So let's look at our like terms. We spent a lot of time on this in last unit. So let's look at our variable term first. I have an 8v and I have a negative 2v. 8 minus 2. So 8v minus 2v is 6v. Don't change any exponents. There are no exponents. You're only looking at the coefficients, which are the numbers in front. So 8 minus 2 is 6. So I have 6v. I'm going to write that just a little bit bigger. And then I have a negative 6 and a negative 18. And so if those are the same signs, I need to add them. So negative 6 and negative 8. Negative 14 equals 4. And now, you know the drill. We're going to get our variable by itself, that v. We're doing reverse PEMDAS, which means we need to move the negative 14 first. So you go ahead and finish it out, and I'll give you some working music. I know, you're anticipating what I'm going to have next. All right, so we added 14 to both sides. I got 6v equals 18. If I divided by 6 on each side, I got v to be 3. Give your neighbor a high five. No, like everybody. Give your neighbor a high five. Thank you. All right, let's see what this next page has to offer us. I'd like for you to try number 10 on your own, please. Try number 10 on your own. It's very similar to what we just did, except you have to distribute twice, which is okay. Remember, when you're distributing the 9, you also are distributing this negative sign, so it's going to change the signs. So take a few minutes. I'm going to give you some music. I need you to work hard. Don't just sit there with your pencil. Try something so that we can figure out where your mistakes are, okay?
This feeling inside. helter skelter. But then again, you know, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you.
I'm writing, so check if you need to.
And you can tell everybody this is a song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down the words.
Alright. If you need to take a time to pause the video, go ahead and do that. Let's look through our answers. You should have C to equal -7. If you didn't, please make sure that you distributed correctly at this line, that your signs are correct, and then when you combine like terms, please make sure you ended up here with 7C plus 42 equals -7. So pause if you need to and take a few minutes to discuss. All right, let's take a look at number 11. And we had a fraction on the front page. And if you remember what we did, we multiplied each side by the reciprocal. But when we did it on the front side, it was 4 over 1. And it's easy when 1 is in the denominator, but here, if I'm going to multiply this side by the reciprocal, I'm multiplying it by 2 over 3, which does cancel here, just leaving me with 10 minus 4d. But if I multiply by the reciprocal over here, yikes, I have 27 over 1 times 2 thirds. Okay, so let's use this space over here on the left. So we have negative 27 over 1 times 2 thirds. Remember, when you're multiplying fractions, you multiply straight across. So negative 27 times 2 is negative 54 divided by 3. Negative 54 divided by 3, use your multiplication chart, and we get negative 18. So again, I multiplied both sides by 2 over 3, and I needed to take a minute and use the other side of the paper to multiply this out. You do have one of these in your homework, and so this is how you handle fractions. So make yourself a note and make your notes legible enough that you can go back and look at this example if you need it. Make yourself a note, multiply by the reciprocal, whatever you need to do. But we know that negative 27 over 1 times 2 thirds gives us a negative 18. And now we can continue the problem. Remember, we're getting our variable by itself. And so, in fact, we leave this negative 4d alone because that's where our variable is, right? This 10, the sign in front of the 10 is a plus sign. So we're really adding 10. So in order to get rid of it, we have to subtract 10. Don't add 18 over. Because remember where your variable is. That's what we need to get by itself, right? So on the left side of the equation, I have negative 4d. These are both negatives, and so when the signs are the same, you're really adding. So 18 and 10, 28, but it's a negative 28, right? Because they're both negative. Now you're experts at this. Divide by negative 4. Divide by negative 4. D is 7. Questions? I know, that was kind of silly because I'm not there to answer them. But you can ask a question to the class. There are people in your class who can help you answer it. Or the teacher who is there today can also try to help. But please, if you have questions, ask your neighbor beside you. You guys have been in class together now for a while. So use someone around you to ask a question. All right, our last example is going to be number 14. And I'd like for you to try number 14 on your own. Remember, first step is to distribute if necessary, and then combine like terms. Distribute if necessary, and then combine like terms, and then you begin to solve the problem. Okay? If you need some help, I'm starting the problem. Okay, check your answers with what I have written. If you need to pause the video, go ahead and pause. Look at what we've done. Again, make sure that when you distributed your 7, that you distributed correctly, and then make sure once you combine like terms, you ended with negative 40 equals negative 18r plus 14. All right, you guys have a good foundation now to be able to begin your work. And so your homework assignment is to do homework 20, which is page 22, I believe. Yes, page 22 and 23, there's 12 problems. So I want you to do 1 through 12 all, please. This is homework number 20, 1 through 12 all.